Welcome one more day to the Techno-Digital School. In today's video, we will talk about the units in Abaqus. That is, what's the unit system that Abaqus uses? Although it may seem like a trivial topic, many times, when we are starting to work with Abaqus, we may come up with this kind of doubts, such as, in which units do I put the elastic modulus of my material? In pascals, megapascals, gigapascals? And what about density? In grams per cubic centimeter, kilograms per cubic meter, or in some other units? And the same applies to force, energy, and any other magnitude. So with this video, we will clarify all the doubts and possible questions that you may have on this topic. For this, we will follow the next example. It is an L-shaped beam with a square section whose base is completely fixed and there is a vertical force of 100 kN applied at the other end. What is the unit system in Abaqus? We say that the system of units in Abaqus is coherent. That is, all the quantities are obtained based on the same fundamental units throughout the entire model. For example, in this case, we're going to take the meter as the length unit, so all the lengths of our model must be in meters. And not only that, but derived quantities that contain length, such as density, will also assume the meter as length unit. Density is defined as mass divided by volume, that is, mass divided by length cubed. Therefore, if we take the kilogram as a unit of mass, we will have to introduce the density in kilograms per cubic meter. However, if we take the gram as the unit of mass, we will give the density in grams per cubic meter. One of the most common and easiest to use coherent systems is the international system, and it will be the one we use in this example. The dimensions of our model will be in meters, and the load in newtons. The units are also crucial in the material properties, which in our case will be a steel with a Young's modulus of 210 gigapascals. So, in the model, since we are using the international system, we will have to introduce that value in pascals, that is 210 multiplied by 10 to the power of 9 pascals. Poisson's ratio is non-dimensional, so we will enter the same value, 0.3. And density is in grams per cubic centimeter, and we actually want to convert it to kilograms per cubic meter, which are the units of the international system. To convert density from grams per cubic centimeter to kilograms per cubic meter or to any other unit, we're going to use conversion factors. The first thing we're going to convert are grams to kilograms. So for that, we write grams below, kilograms above, and the conversion factor will be 1000, since 1000 grams is equal to 1 kilogram. So we already convert grams to kilograms, and now we will have to convert cubic centimeter to cubic meter. And for that we're going to write centimeters above and meters below. We're going to raise to the third power, and 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. Cubic centimeters are simplified, and we have cubic meters left. And the result of all this operation is 7,800 kilograms per cubic meter. And finally, the force is 100 kilonewtons. The unit of force in the international system is newtons. So we will write this as 100,000 newtons or 10 to the power of 5 newtons, which would be the same. The model that we have built in Abaqus is a 2D model in which we assume plane stress, that is, stresses in the direction perpendicular to the screen, that is, in the Z direction, along this coordinate axis will be negligible. The dimensions of the model as we said, are in meters. And the properties of the material, we have introduced them within this material, steel-cyst-int, in the international system. Here we have the density, although we will not need it in this model. Since we're going to use Abaqus standard, it will be a static model. And here we have the elastic properties, Young modulus 210 followed by 9 zeros. Here we can write it as 210E9. And Poisson's ratio is 0.3. As it is a two-dimensional model, we have to specify the thickness of the section, that is, the length in the Z direction. As it is a square section, it is also 0.1 meters. We do that in the section, and we see that the thickness that we have indicated has that value, 0.1. Finally, we must also take into account the units in the load that we have applied. This load has a value of 100 kilonewtons in the downward vertical direction, that is in the negative y direction, and here it is, minus 100 thousandths. And we can go to see the results. Here we have the model solved. We click on plot contours. We're going to see the displacements that we have, and we're going to look at the vertical displacement. So we click here and select U2. Vertical displacements that we have in the model are negative. We see it in the legend. And in fact, at the end of the model, at the tip where we are applying that load, they are around minus 2 times 10 to the minus 2 meters. We're going to make a small change because the legend looks too small. So we go to Viewport, Viewport Annotation Options, select the legend, and we're going to change the font type. Let's choose a larger font, for example, 18, OK. And we're going to change the format. We're going to choose Fixed, Apply. We can already see more clearly the displacement that we have, which is about 2 centimeters downwards. If we look at stresses, for example, we see that the stress values we have, in this case von Mises, are in pascals, because it is the international system, which complicates its reading. So far, we have only talked about the international system of units, but we can choose other systems of units that are coherent, others that allow us to read stresses in megapascals. One of the most common systems in which we use megapascals is the Mesomechanics system. In this system, the fundamental units that we have are millimeters, seconds, then we will see how we have the mass, and what we want to obtain is stress in megapascals, with which the force will be in newtons, because newtons per square millimeter is equal to megapascal. To find out what are the units for mass, we can apply directly that force equals mass multiplied by acceleration. If we transfer this formula to the units of the international system, we have newton equals kilograms times meter divided by square second. However, we do not have meters, we have millimeters. We do have newton and seconds, so we can write it as newton equals kilogram times 10 to the third millimeters, which is 1 meter, divided by square second. And these are our units. We already have millimeters, we have seconds, and we have newtons. Therefore, mass is in 1,000 kilograms. That is, our mass is in tons. If we want to write the density now in tons per cubic millimeter, we will have to convert the value we had before of 7,800 kilograms per cubic meter to tons per cubic millimeter. So we have 1,000 kilograms equals 1 ton. And here we will have 10 to the third millimeters equals 1 meter, all to the power of 3. Cubic meters cancel out with cubic meters, kilograms with kilograms, and we end up with 7,800 times 10 to the minus 12 tons per cubic millimeter. It's a very small value, because we have a very large unit of mass and a very small unit of length or volume, as with millimeters. Back in Abaqus, we have built a model equivalent to the previous one, but in this case it is in millimeters, and if we look at the properties of the material, we see that density is in tons per cubic millimeter, and the elastic properties, specifically Young's modulus, is in megapascals, that is 210,000 megapascals. If we look at the force, we come down here, we see that it is in newtons, as before, because in this system, the unit of force is newtons. And if we come to visualize the results, if we look first at the displacement, we choose again vertical displacements, U2. In this case, we see displacements in millimeters. Now we have minus 20.4 millimeters, which was the same value we had before, that is about 2 centimeters. Likewise, if we plot stresses now, we can see the stress values in megapascals. In the Technodigital School blog, you have an article in which you will find more details about fundamental quantities and derived quantities, as well as other coherent unit systems that you can use. In the description of the video, you will also find a link from which you can download the script to generate in Abaqus the model that we have been discussing, both in units of the international system and in the Mesomechanics system. And that's all. See you next time.